Praise the Lord, my beloved brothers and sisters. What a joy it is to greet each one of you as we gather together virtually on this first Sunday of worship and sacrament. We are blessed, amen, to be able to share in this celebration on today. We are grateful that you chose to join with us on today's broadcast, whether it be on YouTube or Facebook Live or our prayer line. We truly bless God, amen, for the opportunity to gather together and to be able to worship the Lord together. All our worship participants are in place. Amen. The call to worship will be given by the Reverend Paula Jackson. And then we'll have a selection, the opening prayer by the Reverend Jimmy Moore. Scripture lessons, the Old Testament will be read by the Reverend A. Janice Mallory. The gospel lesson by the Reverend Norma Gordon. Let us worship the Lord in spirit and in truth.
Praise the Lord, saints of God, on this glorious first Sunday morning. It's June 6th in 2021. This is our call to worship. When the world is no longer a paradise and creation shows its full power over us still, and we are brought down to size on this small planet of ours, we worship. When the memories linger of the past, and war shapes us beyond our knowing, and conflict becomes a story of life, we worship. When the way is more barren than beautiful, when the path is more a climb than a stroll, when the desert expands and the horizon stretches, we worship. We worship because we can. We worship because we hope. We worship because we know our vulnerability. When things shift and we need to hold on, we worship. It is the only strength we have for the journey. And the church will say, amen.
Oh, Good morning, church. On this first Sunday in the month of June, it's Communion Sunday, we thank God for having brought us thus far. Therefore, we pray as we have been called to without ceasing. So won't you join me in this morning's prayer? Father God, as we approach thy throne of grace and mercy, we approach it, Lord, with thanksgiving in our hearts. For you have brought us thus far, and oh God, we just believe in our hearts that you will continue to bless us as we press our way each and every day, God, with you by our side, because you promise that you will never leave us, Lord God, nor forsake us, but that you will be right there with us, Lord God, even until the end of the world. We thank you, God, because we know that in your presence, Lord, we have liberty, and we stand in need of liberty, Lord, because, Lord God, we are challenged, Lord God, on every side, oh God, by the ways of the world, and we know that we don't have the strength, Lord God, to be victorious without you. But with you, Lord God, we know that we have power to overcome. We thank you, Lord God. And we thank you, Lord God, that you have reminded us over and over again that you are the author and the finisher of our faith. And that it is by faith, Lord God, that we are able to please you. Oh God, we look to the hills from whence cometh our help, because we know that our help doesn't come from us. We don't have the strength or the power, but our help comes from you, Lord. And each and every day, oh God, we are blessed by your presence. Now, Father God, we thank you for having brought us thus far during this pandemic season. And even though we are not clear, Lord God, out of the woods of the pandemic, we know, Lord, as we look back, we can see your hand, oh God, in this entire process. And we believe, Lord God, that we will continue to march forward, Lord God, in victory. Oh Lord God, we lift up those who have been adversely affected, Lord God. Many have lost loved ones. Many are suffering after effects, Lord God. Many, Lord God, endowed with fear, oh God. But we know, Lord God, in your presence, Lord, that your love, Lord God, can erase all of those worldly things. And Lord God, that we can find peace. So Lord God, we pray that you will focus us even the more on your presence, Lord. Teach us, Holy Spirit, to love more, to give more. Oh God, teach us, Lord God, that there is healing in worship, healing in praise. We thank you, Lord God, for all the leadership, oh God, that you have provided, Lord, to help us, to teach us, to show us the way. Thank you, oh God, for having brought us, Lord God, to this point, oh God, where we can see the beauty of your handiwork and we can feel the power of your love. Oh God, you have been so good to us. There were times, Lord God, when our hearts were in a state of wonder, wondering, Lord God, what will tomorrow bring? Oh God, wondering how will we get through our life situations? But now, Lord, we can look back and we can see, Lord God, that you have brought us through, Lord God. Not under our own power, but under your power, Lord. For greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. Thank you for your miraculous strength, Lord God, that you have given us to overcome. Now, Lord, may we use that power to share with others, to help others who are struggling, Lord God. Oh God, we thank you for it. And as we celebrate, Lord God, this first Sunday, Lord, oh God, as we celebrate in remembrance of the blood that was shed on Calvary, in remembrance, Lord God, of that forgiving power that transcends, oh God, all time, Lord God, that is with us even at this moment. May we, Lord God, be obedient, oh God, to your call. Give you the praise and give you the glory. In Jesus' name, let us say amen.
Good morning. Our Old Testament scripture lesson will be read from Ezekiel chapter 34, verses 11 through 16. I'm reading from the New International Version of the Bible. Listen for the word of the Lord. For this is what the Sovereign Lord says, I myself will search for my sheep and look after them. As a shepherd looks after his scattered flock when he is with them, so will I look after my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places where they were scattered on a day of clouds and darkness. I will bring them out from the nations and gather them from the countries, and I will bring them into their own land. I will pasture them on the mountains of Israel, in the ravines, and in all the settlements in the land. I will tend them in a good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel will be their grazing land. There they will lie down in good grazing land, and there they will feed in a rich pasture on mountains of Israel. I myself will tend my sheep and have them lie down, declares the Sovereign Lord. I will search for the lost and bring back the strays. I will bind up the injured and strengthen the weak, but the sleek and the strong I will destroy. I will shepherd the flock with justice. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Good morning, church. I will be reading the gospel lessons, which will be taken from Luke, the 12th chapter, the 22nd through the 34th verses. And I'll be reading from the Contemporary English Version, listen to the word of the Lord. And it is talking about worry. Jesus said to his disciples, I tell you not to worry about your life. Don't worry about having something to eat or wear. Life is more than food or clothing. Look at the crows. They don't plant or harvest, and they don't have storehouses or barns, but God takes care of them. You are much more important than any birds. Can worry make you live longer? If you don't have power over small things, why worry about everything else? Look how the wildflowers grow. They don't work hard to make their clothes, but tell you that Solomon, with all his wealth, wasn't as well clothed as one of these flowers. God gives such beauty to everything that grows in the fields, even though it is here today and thrown into a fire tomorrow. Won't he do even more for you? You have such little faith. Don't keep worrying about having something to eat or drink. Only people who don't know God are always worrying about such things. Your Father knows what you need. But put God's work first, and these things will be yours as well. Now he tells of the treasures in heaven. He says, my little group of disciples, don't be afraid. Your Father wants to give you the kingdom. Sell what you have and give the money to the poor. Make yourself money bags that never wear out. Make sure your treasure is safe in heaven, where thieves cannot steal it and moths cannot destroy it. Your heart will always be where your treasure is. The word of God for the people of God.
Good morning. My name is Jackie Mole. Thank you for tuning in to Allen Chapel's virtual worship services. On behalf of our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Nathan Mugala, his family, ministerial staff, officers, and the entire Allen family, welcome. We are grateful that God has brought us together on this first Sunday in June. I believe that God has something specific that he wants to say on this day, no matter where you are. I want to pose a rhetorical question which does not require an answer. During these last 5 months, can you feel God moving? I believe my spirit heard, yes, I can. Yes, I can. So if you feel God moving, kick off your shoes if you have some on, and let's just worship and praise God. Let me leave you with a thought. Always keep your head up, because if it's down, you won't be able to see the blessings that has been placed in front of you. Again, welcome and have a great week.
Beloved, won't you just join with me as we thank Brother Jackie Moore for that heartwarming welcome today. We praise God and we honor God for him, and I know that you feel welcome to this our virtual worship celebration. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to remind you that our town hall meeting is scheduled for this coming Tuesday, June the 8th, amen, from 7 p.m. via Zoom. This is in preparation for our re-entering of our sanctuary, and we want everybody to join with us as members, amen, and guests as we share information. We also want to remind you that the Women's Ministry of Allen Chapel is inviting all women for their chat and chew, amen, on Thursday, June the 10th, from 5:30 p.m. until 6:30 p.m. You can RSVP by calling our church office at 386-255-1195. Again, we bless God and we honor God for all of you as we continue to serve the Lord in these very difficult times. Ladies and gentlemen, whenever we gather together, we do not come together empty-handed in the presence of our God, but we come together with our gifts, amen, sharing to the honor and glory of God's name. As pastor, I'm grateful to God for all of you, for the sacrifices that you have made to make sure that Allen Chapel is continuing to do the work that God has called us to do. So let me challenge you today, wherever you are, that you will indeed share in the joy of giving, that you will give with your tithes, your public offering, your faith seed offering. You ask, well, Reverend, how can I give? I'm not at the church. Well, right at the bottom of the screen, you can go to Givelify and share with your gifts. Or you can go to PushPay and share with your gifts today. Or you can text to give. Amen. If you can't do any one of those, we encourage you that you can mail in your gift to Allen Chapel AME Church, P.O. Box 9717, Daytona Beach, Florida, 32120. Or you can come by the church office. We have our summer hours, amen, Tuesday through Thursday from 10 until 2 p.m. Again, we encourage all of you that you will share in the joy of giving. Won't you just join with me in prayer as we give thanks for this moment of giving? Father God, we thank you and we praise your name for this opportunity to share with our gifts. God, we realize that everything that we have, God, you gave it to us. And therefore, God, we turn around and give back to you what belongs to you. Bless every giver today. Bless every gift that, God, it will be used to the glory and honor of your name. For it's in Jesus' glorious name we pray. Amen. Sisters, would you just join with me as we celebrate our praise team? Amen for sharing in worship today. We don't take them lightly, but we are grateful to God that they have provided, amen, music during this pandemic, amen, during our virtual worship celebrations, and we praise God for them. Also join me as we thank God, amen, for Sister Tia, who is so dutiful, amen, to make sure that everything is well put together. For our virtual worship celebration, we praise God and we honor God for her. Come on, thank God for all of our clergy. We praise God and we honor God for each one of them. Amen, for their dedication and willingness to serve in difficult times. Amen. And to the entire leadership of Allen Chapel, grateful to God for you, for everything that you continue to do to make sure that we are staying focused on our calling. That God has called us to be able to serve even in difficult times. Now let me invite your prayer for attention today to the Old Testament book of Psalms, Psalm 13. And I will want to look at verses 1 through 6. Psalm 13, beginning at the first stanza, it is here that you find these words. How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long shall I take counsel in my soul, having sorrow in my heart all day? How long will my enemy be exalted over me? Consider and answer me, O Lord, my God. Enlighten my eyes, or I will sleep the sleep of death. And my enemy will say, I have overcome him. And my adversaries will rejoice when I am shaken. Verse number 5, but I have trusted in your loving kindness. My heart shall rejoice in your salvation. I will sing to the Lord, because he has dealt bountifully with me. Won't you just join with me in prayer? Consecrate me now to thy service, Lord. By the power of grace divine, let my soul look up with a steadfast hope, and my will be lost in thine, or the pure delight of a single hour, that before thy throne I stand. With thee, my God, I commune as friend to friend. Draw us near, God, and near to your word, near to your cross. We have come today, God, to hear from you, and any spirit that is not like you, we drive it now in Jesus' name. The spirit of destruction that will hinder us or block us from hearing your word, God, we pray that you remove it right now. God, let your word come with power, the word that will empower us, the word that will indeed deliver us, the word that will heal us. God, have your way in our lives. Now let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, you are my strength and you are my redeemer. In Christ Jesus' name we pray, amen, amen. Beloved, I want to share with you today from this thought, dare to believe. Dare to believe. Beloved, we all go through seasons of joy and seasons of despair. In times of peace and joy, it is easy to sing songs of God's salvation. At those times, we say God is good, that life is great. Yet there are other times, beloved, in life, times when life is hard, when sorrow fills our heart, when things are not working out as we plan, and we wonder if God is even there for us. But I've come this morning, beloved, to declare to you, dare to believe. You have a great destiny in spite of your circumstances. As a young boy, David was anointed king of Israel. Life did not change much for him. He was back in the wilderness taking care of the flock. Sometime later, David went to find the whereabouts of his brothers in battle. And in the process, David ended up killing Goliath. Soon, King Saul appointed him as a soldier. David became so popular in Israel that King Saul became jealous of him. Saul is so eaten up with envy and paranoia that he tried to take David out. On several occasions, Saul had tried to kill David. David, sensing danger, eventually had to flee for his own life. He had been promised the throne, but in reality, he is now in the wilderness, all alone, chest after, and absolutely no hope for the promise to be fulfilled. David looks at the reality of his life and the promises that God had given him and wrote Psalm 13. Listen to how he says it. David says, how long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I wrestle with my thoughts and day after day have sorrow in my heart? How long will my enemy triumph over me? Notice the words, how long? This question is repeated four times in just two verses. It speaks of the very intense desire for deliverance, that David is feeling forgotten by God. He is struggling with anguish and sorrow every day. His enemies are all over him, and he's wondering how long will this go on. The circumstances surrounding his life, it is nowhere compared to the promises that God had given to him. I don't know if you are there today. Maybe that's your situation today. You may be going through some of the similar situations that David was going through. On one side, you have great promises from God. And on the other, you have what talent. You are doing your best. But on the other side, your life is nowhere related to your promise. Can I tell you today, I dare you to believe God. Well, I hear you asking the question, Reverend, help me. How can I believe even when I'm going through what I'm going through? It's part of everything that I'm going through. How can I believe? Well, number one, I want to remind you today that your circumstances don't define your destiny. Can I help somebody today? There are times in our lives when reality is far from our dreams. That is the time, child of God, to trust him because he has promised that he will bring you through, and his promises are always true and faithful. Do I have anybody that knows that God has promised, that if God has promised that God will bring you to pass, that now is not the time for you to quit. Now is not the time for you to throw in the towel. The fact is, you got to understand that that medical report may be so bad, but you got to understand that God is still a doctor in the sick room. That medical report may sound so dismal, but you got to understand that God is still a miracle worker. Your son may never be able to do what you desire for them to be. But if you just keep on praying and trusting God, God has a way of turning lives around. Your child will never improve on their progress report, but you got to understand that God is able to touch their minds and is able to give them good success in his own time. Child of God, I come back to let you know today that you may be struggling with some stuff right now in this season. But I want you to know that seasons come and seasons go. You got to understand, child of God, that no matter what you are dealing with right now, if you just believe in the living God, if you just wait on the living God, that God will bring you through. I wish I had somebody today that will co-sign with me that can be able to declare, Reverend, I've been there. I thought my life was over. I thought nothing was going to change in my life. But God, in his own time, was able to step into my situation. And God was able to make everything all right. Child of God, in the midst of everything, God is telling us, I promise you a great future, and I will fulfill it. Don't quit in hard times. That's a time of preparation, because God is preparing you for what he has in your future. Looking at your fact, you may think that all is over for you, but I want to tell you, God is right where you are. He has plans to prosper you. You may not see a way in the natural, but he is a supernatural God. Yes. He can do what medicines cannot do. Yeah. Yeah. He can promote you without training. He can make rivers in a desert. Mm-hmm. He's not limited by the laws of nature, science, or finance. So don't let the facts blur your vision. But you got to believe that all things are possible with God. When circumstances are against you, trust God's promises for your life. That is the time that you must say, God, I believe you, and I believe that you are bigger than these facts. I don't see a way out, but I believe that God, you are working in the background. Is there anybody that knows that God is always working in the background? You may not be able to see the hand of God, but God is moving in the background. I hear you say, well, brother pastor, I'm glad to hear that, but you don't know what I'm dealing with in my life. You don't know what I'm going through. Well, child of God, I may not know everything that you're going through, but I know somebody that knows everything that you may be going through. I know somebody that knows when you are down, and he will step in, and he will pick you up, and he will turn your life around. Do I have anybody today that can be able to testify that, Reverend, I was down in the valley, I was down in my situation, but somehow the Lord stepped in, and the Lord was able to give me peace in knowing that everything was going to be all right. So I dare you, I dare you to believe, because your circumstances don't define your destiny. But secondly, I dare you to believe. But then you got to understand that unbelief limits God.
Yes.
Well, it's getting quiet now. Unbelief limits God. Unbelief is the biggest tool the enemy puts in our mind. But when you are in a crisis, the devil will give you all the ideas why it will not work out. Yeah. Why you cannot get better. If you believe his lie, he will rob you of your joy. He will rob you of your peace. He will rob you of your destiny. But God wants you to trust him even in uncertainties of life. God wants you to believe him even when you cannot see your way through. In Matthew chapter 13, Jesus, after starting his public ministry, was going back home. Here in his hometown, And the Bible says that family members, his friends, the ones that he had grown up with, did not even believe him. Come on, somebody. They did not even believe that he was able to do anything much. And I believe I do have some folk who are surrounded by some folk who don't believe that you are able to do great things. But child of God, you got to believe what God has said about you. And the Bible has declared that greater is he that is on the inside of you than he that is in the world. Is there anybody in here that can declare, Reverend, I believe whatever God has declared over my life. I know my circumstances may not look good, but I believe that God is bigger than any problem, that God is bigger than any situation that I may be faced with. So I'm going to believe God and not the devil. I'm going to believe God and not a lie. Is there anybody that knows that when you believe God, you come to discover that God is bigger than any situation, is bigger than any problem that you may be facing in your life? Here is David. He's out in the wilderness. He's wondering, where is God? How long am I going to be in this situation? How long, oh God, will I go through what I'm going through? I don't know about you, but I found myself in that place where I've had to ask the question, God, how long? How long will I deal with this? How long will I go through what I'm going through? And God has reminded me over and over that it's simply a season. And if you just believe and never doubt, you will discover that I've got a better destiny for you. You are simply going through. If you just hold on to my unchanging hand, you will see that I will bring you through. I will show myself powerful in the midst of everything that you may be going through. So I dare you to believe, child of God. Your circumstances don't define your destiny. Unbelief limits God.
Yes.
But thirdly, as I hurry to my close, I want to remind you, child of God, that you got to dare to believe, but you got to wait patiently for the Lord's time. It's right there. Remember, God is working on your behalf, even when you cannot see it. A man of faith will say, I will not quit in hard times. I will wait in faith until the promises are fulfilled. Psalm 27 and verse number 14 says, wait for the Lord.
Yes.
Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Many times waiting for the promise can be a painful process. Maybe you are crying out like David in Psalm 13, Lord, how long? I cannot endure this any longer. How long before I see a breakthrough in my family? How long before I see a breakthrough in my life and in my career? I want to tell you this morning, child of God, that just keep on waiting on the Lord. If God has called you, there's a set season of joy and breakthrough coming your way. He has not called you to abandon you at this season. You got to understand that God is still moving even in the midst of everything that is going on. And people have been talking about the pandemic, but child of God, I've seen the hand of God move even in the midst of a pandemic. And I believe that I do have some witnesses who can testify that, Reverend, even in the midst of everything that I've gone through, sometimes lost my loved ones. Some loved ones have been in the hospital for a long time. But God is still in the blessing business. That God is still moving on my behalf. Can I help you today, child of God, if you just learn how to just keep cool and wait on the Lord? It may not come when you want him to come, but God is always, I say, he's always on time. There'll be times of loneliness, times of depression. Probably David did not want to meet anyone, but he said, in spite of what is happening, I will do my best for the Lord. I will sing. I will rejoice. I will trust in the Lord. Do I have anybody here that can declare in the midst of everything that is going on, while I'm waiting on the Lord, that I will sing to the Lord. I will rejoice in the Lord my God. I will praise his name in the midst of everything that is going on. I wish I had somebody that doesn't mind praising God in spite of everything that you may be going through.
Praise the Lord.
So my brothers and sisters,
yes, Lord.
During this season,
yes, Lord.
During this time, dare to believe,
yes, God.
In spite of your circumstances.
Yes, Lord.
God would not have you put your dream in your heart if it was not in his plan to bring you through.
Yes,
God has set times of breakthrough,
yes,
coming your way. God has beauty,
yes,
for your ashes,
yes,
joy for your mourning.
Yes,
he has set seasons of growth and seasons of blessings,
yes,
for your life. You can't give up now,
mm-hmm,
because you are going through what you're going through. I dare you to believe God even for greater things. I dare you to believe God that he will do greater things in your life,
yes,
even in this season. You may have joined us today and say, Reverend, I hear the good word. I want to believe and trust God that he will help me through whatever situations I may be going through. I want you to understand today that when you are in a covenant relationship with God, God has promised that he will never leave you nor forsake you, but that he'll be with you even to the end of the age. Wherever you are, you may be in your home, you may be in your office, you may be in your car driving, and God is speaking to you right now that you need to surrender your life to him.
Yeah.
But the Bible says that if you will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Right where you are, you can get saved. You can begin a new life with God. Secondly, you may have joined us on this broadcast and you are not where you used to be spiritually. You used to be active. You used to be spiritual. You used to be after the things of God. But now you're just going through the motions. Can I encourage you today that you can recommit your life to the Lord? He loves you and is keeping you alive today because he has a purpose for your life. Won't you recommit your life to the Lord today? Finally, you may have joined us on this broadcast. Somebody invited you to be a part of this broadcast, but you're not a member of the church. You have not given yourself to God's church. Yet Alan will be glad to have you. I'll be honored to be your pastor. If you would just call the number 386-255-1195. We want to talk to you. We want to invite you to be a part of God's church family. We bless God for you. Won't you join with us in prayer? Father God, we thank you and we praise your name today. Thank you, God, for your word. And God, we thank you in advance for the response from your people. That individual that desires to surrender their life to you, that person that desires to recommit their life to you, and the person that desires to be a part of the church. God, we ask that you would touch their hearts and their minds. God, move in their life like never before. And God, when you do it, we'll be so careful, so mindful to give you praise and give you glory. For it's in Jesus' powerful name we pray. Amen. Amen. Beloved brothers and sisters, we come again to this sacred moment where we share in the Holy Sacrament. We praise God that even though it's virtual, we can still be able to share and remind ourselves of what Jesus did for us on Calvary, that he was willing to shed his blood for us. Our sacraments have already been consecrated. And so let me invite you now to join with us, amen, in the general confession. Together, Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our mighty for sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against your divine majesty, provoking most justly your wrath nation against us. We do earnest repent and are highly sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past. Save and please you in the newness of life to the honor and glory of your name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Beloved, we will now join wherever you are. Amen. If you don't have the pre-filled, amen, elements, I will encourage you to get some bread, get some water, or get some grape juice. Amen. You'll be able to join with us as we break bread together. Amen. On this first Sunday of worship and sacrament. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ broken for me on Calvary. I take it today, knowing that Jesus Christ, he died, saved me. The precious blood, the blood that was shed for me on Calvary, the blood that has never lost its power, take it today. Knowing that Jesus Christ, he died to save me. Let us join together in the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Rise now, my Father's children. Amen. And let the peace of God go with you. Amen. As you continue to serve and make a difference in our world today. Amen. Come on, put your hands together and give God a praise today for all that the Lord has done for us. And we certainly celebrate his goodness towards us. We just want to remind you, amen, ladies and gentlemen, regarding our town hall meeting, which is coming up this Tuesday, amen, June the 8th, beginning at 7 p.m. You should have received the link. Amen. We invite you to be a part of that meeting as we share information regarding re-entering of our church. Amen. You know that we're coming back into the church next Sunday, June 13th. Amen. Invite, amen, your family, your friends, amen, to come and share with us in our second Sunday, which is our children's / graduate Sunday. We're looking forward to that and coming together and blessing God after being out of the sanctuary for 1 year and 3 months. Amen. God is truly worthy to be praised. We also want to remind you regarding, amen, the women of Allen, amen, their challenge due is Thursday. Amen. June the 10th, beginning at 5:30 p.m. until 6:30 p.m. Amen. If you desire to come, you can call the church office and RSVP. Amen. So they can prepare adequately for you as you come to share with them on Thursday. Again, we bless God for all of you, and we honor God for all of you. I want to show your love again to our clergy. We praise God for them, all of our worship participants. We are grateful to God for all of you. Praise God for more blessings flow. And now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and even forevermore. And the people of God said together, Amen. Amen.